Hello guys, this is Godsent of Scent Farms, and in this video I'm going to show you one of the ways you can make your rabbit farming very, very economical. You won't be spending much in taking care of your rabbit or in your rabbit farm. Just sit back and relax as we get right into the video properly, practically as well. You should know what a rabbit nesting box is by now. If you don't know what a rabbit nesting box is, you want to go back into our gallery, video gallery, and watch the video we made on a rabbit nesting box. That will tell you what a rabbit nesting box is, its uses, the different type of nesting box, the materials, the components of a nesting box. So you want to check that video out. Now, if you already know what the nesting box is, now this video is going to take you a step further into teaching you practically how you can make your own rabbit nesting box in your farm. In that way, you're gonna making your rabbit farming very economical, as you're gonna be spending less money in paying a skilled worker to come and construct a nesting box for you. So this video is going to teach you how you can do it yourself, step by step, all the way. Trust me, with the little knowledge of tool handling that you have, you can make anything, ranging from starting from your rabbit nesting box, and probably you can make your rabbit cage yourself as well. Those are the ways you can save a cost of farming your rabbits. You are welcome to my backyard workshop. Yeah, open roof workshop. Don't mind me, this is where I do my little construction, and this is where I'm going to show you how you can make your rabbit nesting box step by step. And in case you did not get any of the process or any of the step, feel free to ask me either the dimension or whatever the tools you're going to be needing. I'm going to list them as well, so feel free to ask me any questions in the comment section, or hit me up on the WhatsApp number scrolling down the screen. I'll be right there to answer your question as soon as possible, anytime, any day. All right, so let's start with the things you're going to be needing. Is going to be basically these your wood. Yeah, is 1 inch by 6 inches wood. This is 1 inch by 6 inches wood. You can use the 1 by 12 as well. That one is wider than this one, but I prefer using this one for my nesting box. It works fine for me. Yes, of course, you're going to be needing your hammer to drive your nail into the wood. You're going to be needing your panel saw. Yeah, and you're going to be needing some nails. I use nail. Some persons prefer using the screw, but I prefer using the nail. And this is a 2 inch nail. And of course, you're going to be using your, you're going to be needing your tape as well, your measuring tape as well. And that is basically all you need, all the tools and materials you need to make your rabbit nesting box. And in case some persons use these half inch by half inch wire mesh for the floor of their nesting box, but I do not use net for my nesting box. I use the solid wood floor for my nesting box. So that is what I'm going to be showing you guys here on this practical aspect today. So guys, this is an older nesting box. I just want to use it as an example to show you guys the dimensions I use to construct my nesting box. Now, these two long sides you see, I'm measuring 16 inches, while this short side is measuring 8 inches. That is the dimension I use. Different persons can go ahead to use different dimensions, and like I stated in the video of description of a nesting box, it also depends on the door
of your rabbit hutch. If you have a very big door, you can go ahead to do a very big nesting box. That's a semi top covered nesting box. You can do that one. But if you also have enough headroom in your rabbit hutch, you can also do a very big one so that the nesting box will fit in. But the cage system I have now, this is what works best for me. So this is 16 inches by 8 inches dimension. That is what I use. Now I'm going to measure the two long side first and cut it out of this wood you're seeing here. That's going to be 16 inches, which we have here. Let me have that. So this is my 16 inches. I'm just gonna make a mark for the first one, and then I'm gonna cut out the first 16 inches length. Now this is the first 16 inches, and pardon me, I'm not putting on my safety glass, safety gloves, safety first, because whatsoever tools you're working with, these are serrated edges. They are very sharp and it can easily slip and give you a cut on your hand or any part of your body. Then I'm going to use this one now, just to save time, to measure the second one, to mark up the second one, to mark out the second side, and then so as you can see, I have my two sides of 16 inches length each. Then the next one I want to cut out now is going to be the breadth, and that is 8 inches. So I'll just measure out 8 inches. Here's my 8 inches. That is this. This is my 8 inches. I hope you can see that clearly. Same procedure with the, I use this first one to mark out the second one. You can go use your tape to mark out the second one if you want, but I find this process time saving, since I'm going for the same length. Though there might be some slight error, the difference, but it's negligible. Now I have my four sides, cut out my four sides now. What is left to be cut out now is going to be the bottom, and I'm going to do that later, and I can as well measure it out now and cut it now, but I prefer doing it when I have assembled these sides. That I find that very easy to work with. Now with my 2-inch nail and my hammer, all I just need to do is place one of the long side beside the breadth, just like this, as if you want to make a stool. Yes, in my local dialect we call it akaba. So you just place it like this, make sure it aligns on each other, and then with your hammer you drive your 2-inch nail into it. You can go ahead to give up to 2 or 3 nails, as the case may be. Doesn't really matter, it's only gonna give it more strength. I haven't done this. You place this one on the other side as well. And then you repeat the nailing process all over. Making sure it aligns. Now you can see it's pretty easy for me because I've been doing this over the years. I've been doing this and I'm pretty good with working with construction tools. That's why you see it looking very easy. But if you practice it with time, I tell you, it's even more easier than it looks. I'll show you of that. But you want to be careful while hitting the nail so you don't hit your thumb or your finger. Now I have my three sides nailed together. I just put this one on top. Making sure it aligns as well. And then so guys, you can see I've gotten my four sides nailed well, tight and strong. So what is left now is just for me to cover the bottom, that is to cut in the base. Now either way you can do that is either you measure the space or you just go ahead. Just go ahead, place it on top, then you nail before you cut out. Move to the next one, you nail before you cut out. So, but I find measuring and cutting very easy for me, so that's what I'm going to do. Now all I just need to do is to get the length, which is also 16 inches, and I'm going to cut 2 16 inches again to cover the bottom. So guys, now I have my 2 16 inches cut out for my floor. All I just need to do now is place them side by side on the side I have chosen to be the bottom side, and then nail them down to it. Now it's the same principle or the same procedure if you're using the half inch by half inch wire mesh. Instead of cutting this one out now, once you get to this stage, all you just need to do is place your net under. After you cut it to size, then you just nail it and it looks something like this. Yeah, but I'm not doing the net floor type of nesting box. I'm not saying it's a bad one, but it has its advantage and its a disadvantage. But I chose this type of floor to use in my farm. Now, so I'll just go ahead now and drive this floor down using my nail, my 2-inch nail and my hammer. So guys, this is it. It's as simple as that. This is your nesting box for your rabbits. Very balanced and strong. Easy for your rabbits, for your doe to get in. Fits your doe perfectly, no matter the number of liters. I've actually used this pattern of a nesting box to raise 9 kits in a liter. Yes, so it might look small, but it fits them perfectly. The doe just gets in, squat inside, feeds them, and she's out. So this is just it. And you can still see the length of the material that is left. I don't think this one will be able to complete. Almost. I should be able to get almost another nesting box like this from this material that is left. So as you can see now, if I had to go and call a carpenter to come and do this for me, it's definitely going to be charging me some amount of money for the job that he's going to be doing for me. But I have cut that out right now, saved myself that expenses by paying the time and the energy. As you can see, I'm all worked up. Yeah, but it's for the good. So this is how I save cost in running my rabbit farm in terms of construction. Now you see, now don't be surprised if I tell you that these cages that you're seeing behind me, all my rabbit cages that you're seeing behind me, I did all the work. I started with this cage actually, and then I moved on to this one, and then to the one behind these and all that. And I'm going to be decommissioning this cage very soon. I'm bringing it down. I'm bringing this one down. That is just it on how you can construct your rabbit nesting box. Very easy if you follow the step. If you have any question, go ahead, comment section, ask your question, or hit me up on the WhatsApp number scrolling on your screen, and Send Farms is there to answer your questions anytime, any day. Until I come your way next time, see you in the next video. Take good care of your rabbits. Peace out. Bye bye, guys.